I guess maybe I should have cut these flutes a little bit wider so they don't fill with sawdust as much. This one's got much bigger flutes, but only four of them. Another interesting difference here is that this one is actually a little bit wider than the one I made out of a screw. And that's because this screw is always a bit smaller than the hole in the nut. If it wasn't, there would be no slack and the nut would tend to get stuck. And you can see here, this nut has a little bit of play. So by making a thread tap out of a regular screw, you can actually cut the thread a little bit tighter than with an actual tap. And that makes for a tighter fit for the screw, which should give you more hold. The cool thing about this method is that you can make thread taps for pretty much any kind of screw. And for instance, with this wood screw with a very coarse thread, I can still turn that in with my fingers, so there's no risk of splitting the wood or anything like that. And I could use that for a manual fastening or adjustment knob, where I would normally have to use a threaded insert and a machine screw. Because with the threads this coarse, there's plenty of wood that would have to wear away before these threads wouldn't hold anymore. So whether you make your own thread taps out of machine screws or out of bolts for wood, or even if you use metal taps on wood, there's definitely no need to spend a whole lot of money on wood thread taps. I wanted to see how long it would last, but I think I'd wear out that forward reverse switch on my drill before those threads will give out.